First of all, I think we must thank God because all Ugandan staff at the embassy in Beijing, none of them has contracted the COVID-19
since the onset.
Since the onset, and so that's really something good that Ugandans would like to learn about. So the embassy has had no problems, and as far as that is concerned, but of course, it has not been operating at full capacity, because quite a number of us had traveled to Uganda on official issues, and it wasn't possible for us to go back to China. So because of the lockdown here, and the flights also became extremely expensive to go back to China, and also to, everything almost came to a standstill. But of course, life is now picking up at the embassy, and we hope that probably by beginning of new year 2021, the embassy will be working under full capacity.
Right. There was very interesting cases and scenarios when Ugandan students in China had issues, you know, complaining about the pandemic and their upkeep and their... There was a lot of issues. How did that... Because somehow it went off and we don't know. How was that rectified or solved?
That's right. I think we need to remind ourselves because the pandemic actually... started from a province called Wuhan in China. And as a result, we're, of course, our students who are studying in one of the universities there, University of Wuhan something, 70 in number, got affected because the Chinese authorities actually placed that province under
lockdown.
There was no movement, nothing, and so on and so forth. And so it became quite a bit of a problem for Ugandan students there, including even other students, international, even Chinese students, as a result of the pandemic. So, of course, the rest is history, but the government here, the government of President Yoweri Museveni, sent money for kind of upkeep for those 70 Ugandan students, and none of them, fortunately again, and we must thank God, contracted the COVID-19 disease. And up to now, they're still doing very well.